Welcome to the next episode of The Future of Trucking. And today we're going to be talking about emissions and how do you properly calculate how much emissions truly comes from semi-trucks. So as all of you are aware, there's this global shift of let's move off of diesel fuel, let's move to electric vehicles. And the whole reason for that is because we want to reduce emissions and make it better for the environment. So with that, there's really two ways of looking at calculating emissions. There's tailpipe emissions, which is very self-explanatory. It's measuring the pollution coming out of the tailpipe of the truck locally at the vehicle level. But there's also well-to-wheel emissions, which is looking at not only what pollution comes from the vehicle, but also looking all the way back at where did that fuel come from? How was it extracted? How did it get to the vehicle, get used? And then what's the overall emissions profile from well to wheel? And that's our argument, is we should be using well-to-wheel emissions in order to calculate the true emission profile of a vehicle. So let's put some examples to it. So looking at well-to-wheel or compared to just tailpipe. So a BEV plug-in truck, tailpipe emissions is zero, right? It doesn't have any pollution coming from the truck. But there's a massive difference if that electricity to fuel that vehicle is coming from wind or solar, or it's coming from a coal-fired power plant. Similarly, when we look at hydrogen-based vehicles, there is no tailpipe emissions, but there can be a big discrepancy based on where the hydrogen come from as to what the well-to-wheel emissions are. And then with renewable natural gas vehicles or full electric range extender vehicles, you do have tailpipe emissions when that generator is on to charge the batteries. But as we're going to look over the next few slides, we can actually have a much lower overall well-to-wheel emissions profile. So let's dive into some numbers that actually showcase this. So on the bar graph that's being shown, this is a look at California fuels and what the emissions are from those fuels. So we utilize a metric called CI score, the carbon intensity score of a fuel. So in looking at those three different types of vehicles again, to first start with hydrogen, it can range from being anywhere from just slightly negative emissions profile or just slightly below zero, all the way up to close to a 200 CI score. Now, what's really important on this graph is, as you can see, about 100 CI score is the average pollution of a diesel truck. So if you're gonna go above 100, that means you're actually going to be worse than operating a diesel truck. Then when we look at grid electricity, you're in the anywhere from on the high end in the 80s all the way down to zero if you're going to be sourcing it from wind and solar or hydro. Now, one key thing to note with this electricity comparison is this is California's electricity, arguably the cleanest grid electricity in the country, and you can see that it's just slightly better than diesel fuel is. Then when you look at renewable natural gas, this gives you the opportunity to go all the way down to even into like the negative 400s in terms of a CI score. And the reason for this is because you're basically using what would have been pollution to actually produce electricity to power the batteries and run the truck. So since you're using pollution to power the vehicle, it gives you a net carbon negative or below zero emissions profile. So now that you've seen kind of like what the ranges are of the pollution levels for the various fuels, the reason for those ranges is because there's different sources of where the fuel can come from. So let's look at natural gas. There's two different sources or ways natural gas is produced. The first is renewable natural gas, which is capturing methane coming off of land farms. This is RNG, this is clean fuel. And the second is fracked natural gas. Now an interesting stat is even fracked natural gas only has a CI score in the high 70s. So going back to that last table, fracked natural gas is actually cleaner than some of the grid electricity out there. But renewable natural gas allows you to have that significantly low CI score, below zero CI score. And the fun stat with natural gas is 64% of the fuel sold at stations last year came from RNG. Only 36% of the fuel came from fracked natural gas. Now looking at hydrogen, there's two different sources of hydrogen. You've got dirty hydrogen and clean hydrogen. So dirty hydrogen, which unfortunately over 90% of the hydrogen sold last year came from dirty sources. And this is a process that's utilized called steam methane reforming, where you're basically gonna use conventional fuels in order to try to produce hydrogen. It's a, at the end of the day, it's a very pollutive process. That's why when you saw the last table, you saw they could be close to 200 CI score, or almost close to double the emissions of a diesel truck. And then there is clean hydrogen. And this is what's often talked about as hydrogen, right? It's clean, it's zero pollution. And the way that this hydrogen is produced is when you're gonna use wind or solar or hydro, and you're gonna take that electricity and use that to extract hydrogen. Now, that is a truly zero emissions profile, but the problem is less than 10% of our hydrogen that we utilize actually comes from clean hydrogen. Then next, if we look at grid electricity, there's a lot of different sources for it. You've got wind, solar, hydro, which are going to be your truly zero emissions profiles. You also have nuclear as well as natural gas. And then you have some pretty dirty or pollutive processes like coal-based power plants or even petroleum-based power plants. Now, a crazy stat out there is that in the US, some states, over 70% of their electricity come from coal-fired power plants. So it's still a prevalent source of electricity here in the States. But about 20% of our electricity across the US is coming from wind, solar, and hydro, so clean sources. So to step back and kind of recap all of this, so you have the three different fuel sources, BEV plug-in vehicles used in the grid, hydrogen, and then renewable natural gas. In each one of these buckets, you have different sources of where these fuels are being extracted or created, and then each one of those extraction processes has a different CI score, a different emissions profile to it. And then the last thing to look at is, well, how much of that fuel is actually produced from clean sources? So for hydrogen, it's less than 10% of hydrogen is from a clean source. With grid electricity, it's only about 20% is coming from wind, solar, or hydro. And then with renewable natural gas or natural gas as a whole, 64% of the fuel sold at stations last year was already sourced from RNG. So the call to action for fleets is, yes, we want to move to electric vehicles, but we need to look at what are going to be the well-to-wheel emissions profiles of that vehicle when you're operating it in your fleet. So where can you get that grid electricity? Where can you get hydrogen? Or what natural gas can you get? Can you get renewable natural gas? And what CI score comes from each one of those fuels? And so what you want to do is you want to adopt an electric vehicle that's coupled with a low CI score. And ultimately, you want to have a vehicle that can also run on zero tailpipe emissions. And that's going to allow you to not add any pollution into areas like ports or into city areas, or maybe most importantly, like near playgrounds or near schools. And so having a truck that can run on zero tailpipe emissions is critical, but then when it gets into the open road, you can turn that generator on and hopefully be leveraging a fuel that has a low CI score. So ultimately, we need to look at well-to-wheel emissions, adopt fuels that have low CI scores, and have vehicles that are zero emission capable in certain areas. Thanks for joining us.